Hello everybody, welcome back to another quick video that I'm going to be just going straight forward. I'm shooting with it, going with it, and yeah. So I hope all of you guys are having a legendary grand day. Today is an important day, because today is a day that I've officially released one of my artists, and unfortunately probably lost a friend in the process, but we'll get to that in a second. I just feel like I was uncredited and underappreciated, and I didn't think that, you know, someone was grateful for what I've done for them. I shown them something to distribute their music, and we were going to work together with Legendary Grand Entertainment, you know, the music label section, and we were going to start producing a lot of his stuff and shaping his, you know, music career. And we were supposed to work together in a lot of ways. Unfortunately, it seems that Hardcore has made the decision to split ways. I just was talking to him, and I believe that he has made the decision to just go independent and stop working together. I wish and hope the best for him. Completely fine. We ended up making at least one song. So that automatically, I really enjoyed the song. It was clean. It was just two different styles, and it just worked really well. The chemistry bouncing off from each other, it was just, it was an amazing track with a great message, and it just sounded really good. Unfortunately, I sent all of my vocals to the producer, and I mix and mastered my part, right? And I did everything from there, and I uploaded the track. Also, because of what I was going to say, I sent my vocals and the whole track, not the instrumental, because I showed Hardcore the instrumental. He ended up using that instrumental, apparently. I don't know. I'd have to re-listen to the instrumental. I just have a lot on my plate, so, you know, it's not the first thing that I'm thinking of, at least in this situation, and it's also something that I just don't remember the instrumental. So I assume it's the instrumental that I sent him, because that's what he said it was. And so they have the instrumental. I assume they bought the rights to that. And we ended up making that song, and he has all his vocals, and he left a verse, and for me, and that was like the second verse area, and I did my part, and I sent it to them, and for months nothing was done, and other things are being done. He even had the money to upload it to a website to distribute his music, something that I showed him, and he just didn't give me any credit at all. He uploaded the whole album, and at this time, we agreed on, you know, Legendary Grand Entertainment, you know, anything that he does is under Legendary Grand Entertainment. He uploaded the album without no credit to Legendary Grand Entertainment, none of that at all. So I'm like, okay, so he's choosing to be a solo artist. He doesn't want to work with, you know, Legendary Grand Entertainment, which is completely fine. You know, it's his decision. I'm not forcing him, you know, to try to say Legendary Grand Entertainment correctly. You know, he's made the mistake by saying Legendary Grand even in the song, so I had to say Entertainment in the beginning because he did not say the full thing. Completely fine. It sounded good anyways. That I didn't mind. It was a little weird, and I did make a song about it, and, you know, the way he was acting toward me. But I mean, we're from very different places. We're from, you know, different things where things are different and everybody's different. And, so, you know, and we just met off the internet. So, you know, we're still getting to know each other. We don't know each other very well. So he's, not used to how I am, and I'm not used to how he is. So maybe there's been misconceptions and misunderstandings and misinterpretations and such and stuff going on. But from what I understand, I feel like the whole time he just wasn't really wanting to work as much as I did. Maybe he is, though. But I don't know what's going on in his life, because even though he said he wanted to talk, and I asked him if he would like to talk more often, we're not just business partners, but we're also friends. And unfortunately, it seems that today, you know, it really came to show this is what he truly felt like doing the entire time. He didn't let me know that he wanted to release the project. No talks were there. And I know I don't have to make a video talking about these things behind the scenes. It's just, you know, it's kind of important. And I've already talked about working with Hardcore. I've already, you know, made the song and people know about it. And I would just like to inform all the people and let everybody know. Is this going to be uploaded on the Legendary Grand Entertainment channel, including my channel? I don't think it needs to be uploaded on the Legendary Grand Entertainment channel. I think it's an important update for people to know in general. Yes, so it will be going on my channel. But it really would depend on the circumstances for it to go on Legendary Grand Entertainment. And truthfully, I don't think, you know, this situation in general, no matter how it got, would it need to be on that channel. So with all that aside, okay, now that's... That was pretty little bit disrespectful. And this is a very new... I don't know... This is a little different. He's acting a little bit different than he has before, and I don't know why. But going through our messages, he sent me, "Bro, my album is out now." And he said, "I tried to communicate you on Instagram. I specifically told him I'm not going to be using Instagram. I'm going to be using Twitter/X. And he continuously still messaged me on that. But my message was still there, letting him know that I was on X. So, for some reason, that happened. And the last message I sent him, was talking about his album did not say nothing with Legendary Grand Entertainment. It just was, you know, his album. So, yeah. For whatever reason, I made a song called Fake Friends, and he also made a song called Fake Friends. I don't know if that's coincidental or not. I just find it a little interesting. But, you know, I don't know. This is probably the last day I will be in contact with him. I tried working with him, and unfortunately, it's just another one of those situations where they just were not wanting to work. And I feel like I'm doing freaking Call of Duty clans again of how this went. It's always on their side. They're like, "Oh yeah, I want to do this," but in this situation, it's like, "Oh yeah, I want to do this," and he's like, kind of a little bit too much, asking me too much and saying that he wants to do all this stuff. But then he's not putting an effort on working together. He's working, like, more on his part. Which is cool. It's just, like, when I ask you and if you want to work together, he says yes. And he wants to be in Legendary Grand Entertainment. And he's told me many of times. He talks about Legendary Grand Entertainment and highly of it. And then he'll upload his own album without mentioning that. He said in his album he's going to put the song that we made. And it's not there. So, yeah, I really don't know. I guess, he's under his own thing now. He's doing his own thing. Pretty cool. If you want to go listen to his music or his album, go check it out. I'm not going to, mention anybody in the title though, because I just don't have the time for it. but I messaged him, letting him know, can you get back to me? Because it's been like 9 days. He has not told me anything. He's not updated me, not even messaged me on Instagram about anything. All I've gotten from him was saying that his album is going out, and he didn't want to work with me on the album. He didn't let me know anything about that. And he even agreed with, you know, of course, if you're under a label, any label, you're releasing music under that label. Let's say Hobson and Funk Volume, for example. Funk Volume's channel, or, you know, or whatever, YouTube channel, if you will, uploads that person's music At least that's how some of them go. Some of them are on their own individual channel, but they still will have like the Funk Volume logo. And if it was My Music, it would have the Legendary Grand Entertainment logo in the video or something of the sort like that. And it's just, the situation's so weird to me. Like, I never thought hardcore would be, like, so chill. We talked, we were cool, and then it's like this. So, I don't know how it came to this part, but once I get done with this video, I'm just going to, you know, work on what I was doing as I was before. It's just, like, kind of hard because I get spammed, and there's just so much that I'm doing, you know, besides music. And I specifically tell people, could you chill out a little bit and mellow out, you know, just kick back. I understand how much you want to do this, but spamming me is just not the move to do. I don't want to tell you to stop, you know, messaging me so much. I get some people are dedicated to a point, but you can't be dedicated and then, you know, make a toxic decision and then talk to me in a disrespectful manner. That just doesn't make any sense after how respectful it was before. And just, it just, there's no point. So, so he messages me. He's saying, what kind of plans? And I said, I need to know what your plans are. You're working with me and Legendary Grand Entertainment. And he's asking me what kind of plans. He said he was ready to do music, apparently, which I got no word from that, so that is untrue. If he was ready to do anything and wanting to do anything, he would have let me know. That's how that works. And I don't know, again, he's from another country. He's from another place, another state, and another, like, city, town, whatever. Halfway across the globe. So it might go differently there. And no matter, even with that, no matter what the situation may be, he just didn't put in that effort on his end, on his on his freaking end of the bargain, I guess. I don't know. That probably is completely unrelated, the meaning of that. But I mean, like, it's an analogy that I use. It might not even be, like, the right thing that works in this type of situation. But he always, I feel like he uses a excuse over and over again. And he's like, oh, I gotta do everything myself now. He's saying that because he asked me for money. He sent me a website to send him money when he already makes money. He made $60, that's how much it is, to put up his music and distribute it through that website I sent him. So it's a little weird that he still needs money, but he makes that money that he needs. So that's pretty disrespectfully toxic. I don't like that at all. If you're going to work with me, don't ask me for money, for one. You're not going to get money unless you earn that money. He didn't put any work, so why would I send him free money just to help him? Even if I had a lot of money, okay, maybe I'll send him $10. Maybe. But there's a lot of other responsibilities and things that I have to do, and I own a freaking company, so I don't have, you know, all the time in the world, so I can't spend all the time in the world on one person. You know, I gotta talk to this person about this. I gotta talk, you know, just it works in such ways. And it's, I don't know, I just feel like he's coming off in a completely different way than he was before. Like, his mindset's different. I don't know, I very much wish he would have told me about this, because it was that serious to him. The situation really mattered to him. But when it came down to it and I messaged him, he came off, like, a little rude, and that was a little messed. Sorry, I got a message on an app I never use. Don't worry about that. Going back into that, though, I don't know why that actually went off, so try to ignore that. And after we sent that, I said I thought we agreed on this, we were supposed to work together, and then he just repeats the same thing. And then he says a kind of something rude, and it's like, okay, we don't need these things. Like I said, my thing and Legendary Grand Entertainment, my whole company, business, all of that, that works differently than other places. I work how I work. If you don't like how I work, and if you don't want to work with me, then you have to let me know. You can't just be like, oh, I want to work with you, and then, oh, but send me money, I need it, even though I make that money anyways. Like, you gotta choose a choice. You can't be like, oh, this, I promise you all of this, but I'm not gonna work for it. I'm not gonna do these things, but I want you to give me free things, you know, because we're both in this together. Like, no, it doesn't matter where you are. Just like Joshua or Hawk or whatever, when he was in Origins Alliance, he also wanted free things. And in that situation, it's the very exact same thing. He thinks that he won't put in any type of work, but he'll get this free thing and this free thing and this free thing. I don't give handouts. That's just not how this works. Like, in the situations of this sort. And then he says it again, and I'm like, okay. And then he's, this is the reason why I made that song, that I previously mentioned, is because he keeps saying, I never bother to talk to him. Do you not know what a CEO is? Look up the definition of it. Like, I have things to take care of. Yeah, I got a family to take care of too. But do you see me, you know, telling everybody that this is what's going on? And it's just, like, again, everybody's different. Everybody is, you know, just does different things, thinks different ways. And I just don't see why we couldn't just work together, to put it simply. So I'm going to read his last message here. I'm not going to say it out loud. It's just weird, that he's saying that he's waiting. I told him to contact me. I'm not going to message. Like I said, there's a lot of other stuff that I have to do. If he really wanted to start working, yeah, I'm going to get to him and all of that. But, like, there's a lot of other stuff that I have to do. And it's not just this. It's not just Legendary Grand Entertainment. It's not just this music studio, freaking gaming setup combination and all these other things that I do on this. It's not just my entire room that includes Legendary Grand Entertainment and just other things. I have real-life stuff that I have to do, too. There's other things that I have to do. So I know it's self-explanatory. I know it's common sense. And I know I don't have to explain it. But I just feel like I get very tired when people don't understand these type of things. And I know, again, like I said, I don't have to make a video about it. But speaking of bothering, I don't like when people bother me when they aren't going to put in that work that they say they will. Like, I just don't, I don't get, like, it just comes off as negative and very rude of, after reading his thing. Like, it's extremely disrespectful. Like, if it's disrespect you're gonna give me, I'm not gonna wanna work with you. Like, it's not like, oh, three strikes and you're out, I give you three chances. It's just, show me that you wanna work. Come back to me if you wanna work. Because I'm not going to go to you every single time. There's stuff that I got to do and stuff that I do. Yeah, I have a, like, high position. I do those things in the business side of things. But I also do my own things. I do my own streams and my own music and my own this and that. Because it's just what I enjoy and do. I choose what I do with my time. Not every second of the day has to go to one person. Not every hour of the day has to be spent on working on one person's music and distributing it. That is not my problem. So, for guilt-tripping people, it is very disrespectful, and I don't think it's necessary for this, you know, whole thing to happen. So I just deleted the chat, and I think I'm going to leave it at that. Oh, I'm about to hit 100 followers on Twitter. Okay, so yeah, I feel like I would, I feel like I wanted to address this, and I did, and I just, I don't like when people don't take things seriously. If you want to work, don't tell me you're going to work and wanting to work and then not work. You have to think about your decision, choose that decision, because I'm as serious can be, times infinity. That's why, you know, my name is ZX Infinity B, in infinite, not infinity. I mean, you know, you could say that too if you want, but, you know, ZX Infinite, because that's how much dedication and hard work and everything that I do, and I don't even have to explain it. I feel like what I wanted to say is now said, and I feel like I'm going to put the rest of my time doing what I was already doing, and just putting it out there for anybody in the future that wants to work with me, to just, if you want to work, like I said, don't tell me you're going to work and then not work, not let me know about your work, not, you know, contacting me. I mean, it's things that, like, it doesn't require paperwork, it doesn't require this or that, it's just things that it's like, you know, we don't even have to be friends, we can just be business partners and I can still help you out, we can even be friends and not even business partners and I can, you know, help you out, and so on and so forth. But with all that said, it's freaking 2 a.m. in the morning, and I'm not sleeping until I'm done. So, yeah. I probably should get sleep, considering of what's going on today. I probably can't, actually. So, never mind. But I hope all of you guys will have a legendary grand day. Thank you so much for watching. Take care, everybody, and stay happy. And a lot of more content will be coming out. I'm working on music. I'm working on a lot more stuff, and I'm going to be trying to do as much content as humanly possible, or, you know, even more than that if I can. Doing what I can, as you can tell, there's a lot I have to clean up. I'm almost done with getting all that done, and then I can, you know, finally kick back and start doing more things. And it'll enable me, once I get everything, you know, cleaned up, to be able to do different types of streams, different types of content, different types of music, and just so on and so forth. So, yeah, if you have any questions, comments, or concerns, if you want to leave any questions in the comment section below, if you want to discuss, go ahead. I'll join the conversation. And if you guys have anything you want to let me know, then let me know in the comment section below. But that's all I have to say about this. I really hope that, you know, I don't have to talk about this again. And I feel like it was already something that this video was going to end up having to be anyways, because of the stream, you know, me asking Hardcore to say Legendary Grand Entertainment, you know, like the name is called, and it's fine, and I've explained everything in that video. I don't have to re-explain it, but it's just a simple mistake that's completely fine. You know, it's just missaid. It's not even a word, but I'm saying it. So it is now a word. It was said incorrectly, and again, completely fine. It wasn't done by purpose, and if it was, well, that was just them saying it wrong. Simple as that. Saying it incorrectly. And then just the random disrespect at times, and then today being the most disrespectful he's ever been. So yeah, this video is most likely going to be called also, I'm no longer working with Hardcore. So, yeah. And he's not a part of any of this anymore. But I do wish the best for him, and hope the best for him, as I said. You know, saying it more than once so people can understand that it's, you know, it's nothing hateful at all. It's nothing, I don't feel anything bad towards this guy. I tried to be his friend, and it didn't work. So, you know, he's still in LGE. He's just not in, you know, working with us. He's just in it, like everybody else is in Africa, and everybody else is in Russia, and everybody else is on the eastern side, and everybody else on the western side, where I'm at, and then globally, northern and southern, and so on and so forth. So yeah, I'm gonna finish what I'm doing. I appreciate all of you guys watching this video, and that's all that I have to say. HomieZack710 is out. Later, peeps. Thank you.
Fake Friends was about him because he just discredits me. It's disrespectful. I don't hate him. But I hope the best for him. If you're going to make a song called Fake Friends because I did, don't make a song. Don't make it a topic of a song. Just message me. Talk to me about it. I'm not going to go back and forth. I'm not going to do none of that. Just, if it doesn't matter to me that much, but if I was a fake friend to you, then that explain how much it mattered in that thing. But it really doesn't matter. Take care.